It doesn't matter whether you've got cheap or expensive tyres, perhaps winter or summer tyres, or even tubeless or clincher tyres, because when it comes to installing new ones on your bike, it's going to go one or two ways. They're going to go on like a breeze, and you'll wonder what all the fuss that some people make was about. Or you're going to have an absolute nightmare. You're going to shout, you're going to swear, and you're going to walk off in a huff and wonder what the hell to do next. Which is where this video comes in, because I am going to go through some helpful tips and guidance on how to install even the most difficult of tyres onto your road bike. Boom. First up, if you want to support our channel and like what we do, consider subscribing to GCNTech. And also, if you want to learn even more about fixing your road bike, why not consider our road bike essential maintenance book, available at shop.globalcyclingnetwork.com. Now, when it comes to installing tyres onto your road bike and you're running into some difficulty, it's because of two main reasons. Reason number one is to do with the manufacturing tolerance between the tyre and the wheel interface. And reason number two is purely down to technique. We're going to run through some advice on how to overcome those issues in just a minute. But if you are using a tubeless tyre, they are going to be a tighter fit purely by their design. When it comes to the manufacturing tolerance that I'm talking about, we are talking about small differences here. And when it comes to the wheel rim, the difference that we're talking about is the overall circumference of that inner bead surface, which is the area where the tire sits on. And if you're running into difficulty, chances are that the wheel and tire combination that you are using are at the extreme ends of that small little manufacturing tolerance that there is, which means the wheel rim bead is ever so slightly on the larger side, so you have an overall circumference which is slightly larger than what you're anticipating. And then when it comes to the tyre, the manufacturing tolerance on the tyre is towards the smaller side of things. So what you're essentially trying to do is fit a slightly small tyre onto a slightly large wheel rim, and that is where things start to get a little bit difficult. The easiest and most obvious step, if you haven't tried this already, is that when you've got the tyre onto the wheel and you're really struggling to get the last little section of tyre bead up and over the wheel rim, is to make sure that the tyre bead is located down in this central wheel well before trying to get the rest of it on. You see, if you look down here, this wheel well is lower down than the little bead shoulder, which means overall its circumference is smaller. So by having the tyre bead in that section, you're creating additional slack in the tyre bead to give you the space to get the tyre up and over onto the wheel. It's also worth noting that I would suggest starting putting the tyre on opposite the valve and trying to finish at the point where the valve is. The reason for this, particularly if you're using tubeless tyres, is that sometimes the wheel valve can remove some of that spare slack that you've got and will make putting the tyre on a little bit difficult. If your tyres are a really, really, really tight fit, which I'm going to assume they are, hence why you're watching this video, you can kiss goodbye to installing your tyres with nothing more than your hands and your strong thumbs. And you are 100% going to need one, if not two, tyre levers to get the job done. Now, tyre levers, there's loads of different options out there, some cheap, some expensive. The advice I would give is to invest in a good quality set. They can either be made from nylon, or if you run into difficulty with tough fitting tyres all the time, you could get one like this, which has got a metal core and a nylon outer cover. That way, it reduces the risk of damaging either your expensive wheels or your expensive tyres. And the reason some tyres are going to be super tight to fit, 9 out of 10, is because they're brand new in the box. They haven't been fitted onto a set of wheels and inflated, which is going to help stretch them. Chances are this is the exact point where you're going to run into a little bit of difficulty trying to get that last section of tyre bead up and over onto the wheel rim. And no matter what you try, you just don't seem to be able to get it all the way over. Now, I've heard of tips such as trying to warm up the tyre on a radiator, trying to pre-stretch the tyre to make it ever so slightly larger, and also using a slightly thinner rim tape in the wheel, all of which I think will help a little bit. But I think the most important thing to try before doing all that is to simply use a small amount of lubricant onto that section of tyre bead, and it's going to help it slide up and over the wheel rim. In order to do that, you need to get yourself a GCN or GMBN mug. I think this one worked. Other mugs are available, but might yield slightly different results. Put yourself a little bit of washing up liquid or mild soap, or if you're American, dish soap into this, a little bit of water, and you've made yourself a soapy solution. You can then take that solution and put it onto that difficult section of tyre bead. Make sure that the rest of the tyre bead is in that central wheel well, and then using your tyre lever, which I placed over there, start to hold one section in place with your hand and work the rest of the tyre over onto the wheel rim. To use the soapy water method, you're going to have your tyre pretty much set up ready to go. So if you're using an inner tube tyre setup, you need your inner tube inside and the rest of the tyre bead seated on as best as you possibly can. If you're running a tubeless tyre, depending on the sealant that you're using, you've got two options. You can either have the sealant into the tyre and then rotate the tyre so the sealant sits at the bottom where you've got that section of tyre already inserted. Or you can not put any sealant in at all and then inject it through the valve at a later stage once you've got this tyre seated correctly. Now, the first thing you're going to need to do is remove a little section of tyre bead back ever so slightly further than the section where you run into a little bit of difficulty. Take your finger, dip it into your soapy water solution, and then apply that on this inner edge of the tyre bead. Work your way all the way around. And I wouldn't worry about trying to get it around the outer surface, because if you get it on the outside, it's just going to make the tyre a little bit slippier and harder to get hold of. Once you've applied a tiny bit of this soapy solution, wipe your finger off on your shorts or a cloth if you've got one to hand, and then get the tyre on as best as you can with your hands, which is pretty much this stage here. At this point, you can keep one hand onto one side of the tyre bead to stop it popping off any further. Take your tyre lever and then carefully insert it underneath this section of tyre bead, ready to lift it up and over. Now, if you're using a tyre which has an inner tube inside, this is the stage where you do need to be super, super careful not to pinch the inner tube with your tyre lever. To help avoid this, an easy method to do is to have a small little bit of air into the inner tube to help it hold its shape. But as you're doing this, you just need to be really careful and methodical and put a little section over, work your way around like so. Little section over, move around and progress your way around. The easiest thing to do here is do a small section at a time, like so. It's all about being slow and gentle until you're at the point where the last little bit is really pop. Look at that. A lot of people are going to say that was an easy one, but there's more difficult ones out there, but that was definitely one that has to use the correct technique. Once you're happy you've got the tyre all the way on, check the entire way round the wheel rim to make sure it's all seated correctly on both sides, which this one is, and then you can move on to inflating your tyre and pretty much away you go. Now, if you're running a tubeless setup, don't forget to install your sealant, and also don't be alarmed if your tyres go down overnight for the first time. Simply pump them up the second time, go for a short little ride, and that will get the sealant to go everywhere in the tyre, and then it should stay inflated, ready to go. And as with all maintenance tasks, this really is one that the more you do it, the better you're going to get at it. And I would probably suggest, for the first time you go to set up a new set of tyres, I'd avoid doing it the night before you're going out for a big long ride. Give yourself some time and yeah, as I said, practice makes perfect. So there you go, installing difficult tyres. Whilst it is a pain, it's certainly not impossible. And the more you practice and the better you perfect your technique, the easier it will be. Yes, there's going to be lots of different wheel and tyre combinations out there that you're going to get different results with. But use those techniques correctly, and I'm pretty confident in saying there will not be a tyre that defeats you. Anyway, hope you've enjoyed this video. If you have, please do give it a big thumbs up. If you have any questions, let me know in the comments section down below. And also let me know if you have a wheel and tyre combination that you think is impossible to get the tyre to install onto. And do you know what? I'm going to offer to help everybody out. If you're really struggling and think there's a tyre that's impossible to get on, feel free to send it into GCN Megabase or just drop by on a Tuesday afternoon and I'm sure I can help you out. Right, I'm out of here. See you later. See you on Tuesday. I'm going to regret that.